Carlo Vergara
of Sasha Saturn.
Magandang hapon po. Okay, so just to see who's here, who are the aspiring creators? Okay, meron dyan. Sino dito ang wala lang? Okay, meron namang wala lang. Thank you very much for coming over. Okay, and of course, the rest, I'd like to believe our readers. Thank you so much for dropping by. My name is Carlo Vergara. I just turned 46, and so that makes me one of the seniors going towards veteran status. So, yun yung jiljo ko kay budget na parang, ako, budget, talaga na yung time. Veterans na tayo, ganyan. Ang tanong, tatagal ba tayo na umabot ng veterans? Because there was a time recently where I posted on Facebook that I was thinking about quitting comics. And it was a very, very emotional time for me. But, you know, before we get there, backtrack muna tayo. I will try and condense 40 years of my life in 30 minutes. Relevant naman siya dito sa pinag-uusapan natin. I was more of an illustrator than a writer when I was young. I started drawing, sabi ng nanay ko, 4 years old pa lang ako. Nagdo-drawing na ako, although I don't really remember that. Tapos yung mga influences ko while growing up were Voltes 5, ganyan. Tapos dinodrawing-drawing namin yung, ano, yung Go Ranger, mga ganyan. Basta yung, that whole gamut of anime and sentai shows during the 70s, yan. Yun, Mondays, Nekanda Robot, Tuesdays, Daimos, Wednesdays, Mazinger Z, Thursdays, UFO Grandizer, Fridays, Voltes 5. Yun, yung ganon. Meron sa Channel 7, meron sa Channel 9, meron sa Channel 13, ganyan. Ngayon, eventually, when I reached college, that's when, in De La Salle, sumali ako dun sa school paper, De La Salle yan. Tapos, art department, we were supposed to make comic strips, so that was the first time na I got published as a comics person, and this was in 1988. Okay, who was not born in 1988? Sino wala pa, who did not exist in 1988, ayan. So yeah. And then, after college, I worked in LaSalle, sa PR office nila. And in LaSalle, there's this group called the Ruffers. Okay, sila yung official geeks ng De La Salle. They were into manga and anime and role-playing games and ganyan. So I found a home with them. Kasi nung high school, nag-Dungeons and Dragons ako, Dungeon Master ako. Yung binalo namin, Dungeons and Dragons. What else? Marvel Superheroes RPG, DC, role-playing games, ganyan. Pati yung White Wolf, pinatulan na namin. Yun, yung mga vampire, mga mage, yan, ganyan. And then, so one of my friends in that group, Alex Santos, who I know now is a teacher in Xavier, sabi, Carl, gawa tayo ng comics, ganyan. Ako naman, sige, okay, ganyan. I've never done a full comic book before. So we had our friend, David Contiveros, write the script about a Pinoy group of superheroes called Flashpoint. And we released it through Expressions. You're familiar with Expressions, the bookstore, the small bookstore chain. So we released it. And what we didn't know was there were other groups during the time in the early 90s of Umagwa then. So you had Budgetan and Arnold Are, and they were doing Alamat 101, tapos dito sa sites na Gilbert Monsanto, sina Louis Antonio, they were doing Exodus, and these other, small splinter groups, ganyan. This was the early 90s, kasi during that time, pawala na yung Newsstand Comics, or it's almost dead, ganyan. So we wanted to revive the comic book industry, ganyan. We wanted to be, parang yun. Meron kami yung ego trip during that time. And then, but, things happened. We had a few conventions. Yung mga conventions na pala artwork ng comics, yung ganong type. Eventually, in the late 90s, Arnold Allen released Mythology Class, won the National Book Award, and personally, naiingit ako na parang umabot sa ganon yung local comics, yung parang naging recognized siya by critics, ganyan. So naisip ko yun, I'm gonna make my own, pero testing lang muna, 56 pages lang. Ganyan. So I did One Night in Purgatory, which is, for those who don't know, One Night in Purgatory is just, hindi siya superhero drama lang siya, about two guys, na one straight and one gay, and they were best friends but eventually had a relationship. Ganyan. So One Night in Purgatory is about the night when they met up again. Ganon. So maiksing kwento lang. It got a finalist slot sa National Book Awards. And the following year was Josh Saturna, 2002. Yun, self-published pa. Pinagastusan. So out of pocket yung printing press, ganyan. Because during that time, most of my peers were doing risograph or Xerox comics. Sa loob-loob ko, gusto ko naman gumawa ng through the printing press naman. Ganyan. And yun nga, yung luckily, yun nga, it won the National Book Award. I had it coursed through Visprint, and we had the compilation coming out in 2003. Yun. So it was during that time nga na parang wow, okay. Parang that was like a big milestone para sa akin. And then suddenly, you had 5 movie companies contacting you for the rights. Okay? So, one of them, of course, was Regal Films. Which I eventually chose because they gave the best deal. Okay? There was a TV production house that wanted to do the series, but this was in the early 2000s. Hindi pa lumalabas si My Husband's Lover, wala pang mga ganon. So, yung talukos kanila, parang, how can you create a TV series headlining a homosexual character? During that time, it was like unheard of, unthinkable, ganyan. Inaalala ko, baka hindi mag-great yan, baka hindi kayo mako ng advertising, ganyan. So that didn't materialize. But I was also contacted by Tanghalan Pilipino, the Cultural Center of the Philippines, for the musical. So in 2006, I had a musical in February and a movie in December. So yun nangyari. So it was like a whirlwind year for me. I had a full-time job din at that time. Yung ganon. Now, during that time na 2006, and people were asking me, okay na yung sequel. Hindi ko alam kung paano gumawa ng sequel. And then I realized na hindi ako marunong gumawa ng kwento. Because everything that I've been doing was instinctual. This is how I felt a story could be made. I didn't know anything about yung tiyatawag nila story structure, through lines, character arc, setup payoff. Wala akong kaalam-alam doon. Everything was just like bukso ng damdamin, ika nga ganyan. And I was doing that when I did Zsa Zsa. For those who don't know, I was going through a period of depression. So Zsa Zsa was my way of going through an emotional time. So sabi ko nga sa friends ko, Diyos ko naman, ayaw ko naman ma-depress ulit. Ito nga gumawa ng libro. Parang every time gagawa ko, kailangan ako ma-depress ulit. Parang hindi yata tama yun, di ba? So, what I did was, I stopped making comics for a while after Zsa Zsa. I did draw comics for a US-based publisher, Graphic Classics. Pero while I was drawing stuff for them and doing my full-time job, I was studying. So, order ako ng books sa Amazon, yung mga online courses, ganyan. Paano ba gumawa ng kwento? Yung gano'n. Yung technical, yung ganyan. The technical way of constructing stories. Yun ang pinag-aralan ko. So, and then you realize nga, oh, may pattern pala yung sinasabi lang formula na hindi pala formula, yung ganon. And for those who are thinking of making their own stories. Yon, that's the first thing talaga. Learn story structure. It is the most powerful thing you can learn in making stories, and it has helped me a lot until now. So, what happened? So, dumaan na ako doon sa period na yun na, okay, I think I know how to make a story, I think. So, I decided I'm gonna make Shasha sa tour na sa Kalakang Maynina, which until now is not finished yet. But I'll finish it this year, promise ko yun. So, yun ang, parang yun yung parang testing ko sa sarili ko pagdating sa comics. Culminating thesis, kumbaga, of all I've learned. And then, on the side naman, who has heard of the Virgin Love Fest? Okay, so the Virgin Love Fest is a playwriting festival in the Cultural Center of the Philippines. They have it every year. And essentially, it's you submit your play, and if it gets accepted, it gets staged. Yun. Maliit lang yung the token cash is maliit lang. Pero the thrill of having your work actually staged, parang magandang reward na yon. So parang sinabi ko sa sarili ko, okay, I'll test myself nga, parang apply again. So I wrote a play kung paano ako naging leading lady, which is a play about the maid of a superhero team. Yun. One act play lang siya. So it's just three characters. You have the maid, yung sister ng maid, at saka yung leading man. The one with the telekinetic ring. Ganyan, na guwapo, na English spoken eh. Who falls in love with the maid. And then the sister is actually a lackey of the supervillains. Ganon yung ano. So may fight scene, ganyan. It was directed by Chris Martinez. If you're familiar with that film director, so siya yung direct ng play. And in the tradition of Lab Fest, if you're in the top three best place among the slate of 12 that were chosen, you get restaged the following year. So I got restaged. Tapos na lumapit. Sir Carlo, pwede nga ba namin gawing musical yan? So, musical again? Ganyan. So I this was like from out of the blue. Someone from the audience has approached me and nagkataon na they were setting up a theater company and asked me if I wanted Leading Lady to become a full-length musical. Siyempre, ano sabihin mo? Sige, game. Ganyan. And there goes again the new process na ako na ang magsusulat ng full script. So it was a matter of taking that small story, three-character story, the maid, the kapatid, and the superhero, and expand it into a full-length story with the superhero team, the supervillain team, the family of the maid, and what happens between them. Ganyan. And it was staged in March 2015, starring between Escalante and Frenchie D, along with Marky Strom and these big people in theater. So we had like over 40 shows of that. And incidentally, Ateneo is doing it this year in April. So they're doing their version of the Leading Lady musical in Ateneo. So every year, nagsusulat na ako for Love Fest. And out of the four times na nagsubmit ako, three have been staged. So the second one, The Missing Piece, is about what if there's a prophecy that says if the Philippines wins five of the major beauty pageants in one year, there will be world peace. So yun yung premise ng play. Ganyan. The third one that I submitted to them, Mula sa Kulimliman, is essentially about what if there's this ordinary wife and discovers that her husband is actually panlay? Yung ganon. So imagine the scenario, itong wife na ito, nagpapakandahirap sa keeping the household running, meron siyang anak, parating wala yung tatay kasi may trabaho daw sa construction, ganyan. So nahihirapan si wife, ganon. Tapos, kaya kaya, dumating na si husband, so happy-happy, ganyan-ganyan. And then suddenly, there's this little discovery and the husband has to reveal na with sword and costume and everything na I'm actually a warrior from this other dimension. Naloka si wife. Nagkakandahirap ako dito, tapos doon ka na gano'n? Hindi naman, hindi totoo ang mga tao doon. Dito totoo, may asawa ka, may anak ka, ganyan. So yun yung premise. Yun. So, and because of that, yung one film director approached me if I wanted to have it expanded into a full-length film. So, and it was pitched in some directors pitching session one time, pero hindi lumusot kasi hindi parang kompleto yung kwento. So that's one of the things that I want to explore in the future. Now, I'm submitting again for LabFest, and it's medyo historical din naman na may fantasy. Now, the question that, when we're talking about the topic of super stories, especially for comics, yung ang napapansin ko, the stories that have made me or that have brought me to where I am right now is number one, the ultimate connection with the audience. Yung meron kang tinatamaang little something inside of them, whatever topic that is. For Zsa Zsa, it's the gay thing. And of course, there's the Ada Dodong thing na, you know, yung parang everybody deserves a Dodong kind of thing, that little hukot thing going on. For Leading Lady, nandyan yung, it's the same thing. You have the maid, you have this super dashing superhero falling in love with the maid. Who doesn't like that? Ganon. Mula sa Kulimliman, it's that thing about, you know, yung paghihirap natin bilang Pinoy, na we want to keep the family together despite everything, ganyan. Pero ang ginagawa ko, I place this, I encase it in this fantasy thing. So, there was someone who told me, this theater reviewer who said na, at least in theater, ako pa lang ang gumagawa noon. Na I take a social cultural reality and then wrap some fantastical thing around it. Ganyan. So, not only does it hit the heart, it also activates the imagination. Yung ganon. So, yun ang nakita kong what the super story is about. Going back to my thing about why I'm quitting comics. Ganyan. It's so easy to blame the reader, honestly. Kasi yung parang sinasabi ng mga ano, when I would read forums about how do you save Filipino comics, ganyan, ganyan. And people were saying that more people should read it, ganyan. More people should read it. Our distribution system sucks, ganyan. We're getting no support, ganyan, ganyan, ganyan. Pero yung sa akin is more like, ako personally as creator, I have a responsibility. I have a responsibility to create the best stories I can possibly make for the most number of people that I can. Ganyan. Awa ng Diyos, kapag may show kami sa theater, I would bring my books. Marami siyang lubenta. And these are like people who have not touched a comic in years. And they pick up the books. So, that gives me hope. Na, I would also like to think that when my first Zsa Zsa book hit the bestseller list for National back then, I would also like to think that it's because there was the movie and the stage musical. People who did not know that comic books existed again, parang nakapasok sila sa comics again because of these other mass media adaptations. So I'm thinking na parang is that an avenue? Parang is that an avenue that some comic book creators can take to create work that can possibly be pitched and adapted in other media so that those people in those circles can be attracted to our space. Yun. So, yun yung mode ko ngayon actually. So, one of my stories, and I will tell you right now, And I tell you right now, the new movie that we're working on with Regal is Leading Lady. So that's for, I know some of you are bloggers, huwag muna niyo sabihin, ganon, kasi we're still ironing out the ano. Pero I'm currently working on the screenplay of that. My deadline is next week. So yun. And apart from that, yung nanganganak din. So right now what I'm doing is, I'm trying to finish Zaturna Part 3. I have a deadline with Regal Films for the Leading Lady screenplay. Plus, I'm doing something for TV, which is not superhero related. They just got me because of what I did for LabFest. Yung mga kwento ko sa LabFest na gustuhan nila. So, someone asked me, Carlo, pwede ka bang sumali dito sa writer's pool for this TV series? Sabi ko, okay, pero I cannot commit to all I can only commit to like 25% of the episodes. Parang ganon. Parang konti na lang kaya kong gawin. Pero it is a foot in the door for me as a creative. Ganyan. Hopefully, it will expand my audience. I don't know. Right now, we are doing story development work for that series. They want it out in July. Kaya, yun, busy-busyhan, ganon. So for those who are aspiring to make comics or stories in general, yung pinaka-advice ko lang naman is to level up. Level up whenever you can. You start small, then with every success, you level up. Number two, go outside your circle. Go outside your circle. I am primarily a comic book creator, but I stepped into theater. And because I stepped into theater, I stepped into film. And because I stepped into film, I got stepped into TV. So then, yeah, yung parang nag-expand lang yung horizons mo. But ultimately, you will still come back home. Comics pa rin, ang nasa puso. Okay.